Once you start working on large worksheets, at some point, either for presentation sake, readability, or print layout, you may want to hide or group certain rows and/or columns. Although similar, they work a bit differently and serve different purposes. To hide a row, select it, then right-click and scroll down to hide row. You can select rows to hide individually, but that's inefficient. To unhide the hidden rows, click on the tiny up and down arrows on the left of the row numbers. Once you unhide, you clear the hiding option. To select multiple rows to hide, press Shift while selecting. To select multiple rows that are non-consecutive, press Command on Mac or Control on PC while selecting. Then right-click and select Hide Rows. What I like about this is that Google Sheet is smart to recognize not to hide all of the rows together, but keep them separate in small groups. I'm also going to hide few rows at the bottom of our worksheet. If you have many hidden rows or columns, instead of having to unhide them individually by clicking the tiny arrows, you can select rows before the first selection and after, and then right-click to unhide all. Hiding is okay if you want to quickly conceal content for printing or safeguarding sensitive information. However, it is hard to identify the hidden rows and columns. Additionally, once you unhide the data, you would need to repeat the process to hide again, which is inefficient. Grouping is an alternative to hiding. It provides clearer visibility of hidden content and is better choice for a more permanent organization. It offers a more efficient way to reveal and conceal your data quickly. To group rows, select them, then right-click and scroll down all the way to view more row actions, then select the group option. This is a bit cumbersome. If you click on the minus square next to the grouped rows, they will collapse. Another way to group, which is a little faster, is by going to View, Group, Group Selected Rows. But even this way can be cumbersome if you have to make many groups, so you can use the keyboard shortcut. Now, don't try to remember it. Just go to View, Group Menu, and you will see the shortcut for your computer. You can use that for the next few groups you have to make. In my case, since I am on Mac, my shortcut is Shift, Option, Arrow Right. If you have a PC, it's Alt, Shift, Right Arrow. Once I'm able to use the shortcut, it is a very fast process. Once I created all these groups, they are all open. And if I want to collapse them all, I would have to keep clicking on these tiny minuses. That's too much work for me. And then if I needed to expand them all, clicking on each one just makes me a little frustrated. Well, there is a faster way to expand and collapse them all at once. Right-click on the minus or plus and select Expand All Row Groups to have all the rows visible. Wow, that was so easy and fast. I like that. You can also do the other way, right-click and collapse all row groups all at once. These options are super helpful for large data sets. Another thing you can control is where the expand, collapse, plus or minus signs is. You can position it up or down. I personally like having it down, similar to Excel, because I use both software frequently, I like to keep it consistent. Now with grouping, you can create hierarchy of information. We can group all the subgroup expenses so that we only see the grand total expense number. To remove any group, you can right-click on it and select Remove Group. All the hiding and grouping options work the same way for columns. I can select multiple and then use the same keyboard shortcut to group it. You can see how clean my worksheet looks, and I still have all the data. It is just collapsed from view. It is a perfect summary of all the information. Now, to remove all the groups individually is tedious. You can try selecting all rows before and after all the groups, right-click and select Remove Group, but that doesn't work. The way to do it is through the menu. Once selected, go to View, Group, and Group Rows. Most of the time this works perfectly, but sometimes what it does, for some reason it converts the groups to hidden rows, which I already know how to select all and unhide everything. Thanks so much for watching.